Hello everyone, welcome. We're still in chapter 1 and this lesson is very important because we are talking about the cursor, we are talking about the snapping, and we'll see how we can manipulate the origin. It's very simple, so let's dive into the scene. I am here and we have, as I have mentioned before, we can show statics or display or hide. Here we have the cursor. You can move the cursor or using shift right click, so you can move your cursor. What is the origin point? We have here four items and all of these four items are one object, so the origin is here, which if you want to rotate, it will be rotated around this origin. I want to make the origin maybe in this space, so I will select this face and click shift S. It's been a lot of options and we are aware of the cursor to be the select, so I will select the face which I am selecting now, and after that I will go to the object mode and from object set origin to the 3D cursor, and now the origin has been converted or have been moved, transformed to this face, and we can now rotate in the y-axis or maybe rotate in z-axis, and again I will select maybe this edge and delete this step, and cursor selected, again go to object, set origin to the 3D cursor. Now I can rotate from this origin or scale from this origin, scale in the x-axis. What next? I want to move the origin to be the geometry. We have here a lot of options, so you can go to move the origin to the geometry. It will be here. It's an mass, so Blender automatically calculate the origin, so it can be moved to another point. What about the snap? Before the snap we have some object here, and we can make and separate this by selection by using B, so the shortcut is B, and we can select all of these linked vertex and separate by selection, again select all of these items and separate by selection. It should control L, separate by selection. Control L, separate by selection. So we have here some items. What is awesome about Blender 2.9 is that you can select many items and tab, so we can manipulate and edit in the same time. And this feature is new and wasn't in the previous versions. I want to talk about the join. We have here a few items, so we can select all and control G. Maybe we have here a sphere, maybe we have here a cylinder, and I want to make all of these items to be one object. Now I will go to the face orientation and maybe using a matte cap, which may be this one. All right, let's dive again. After join I want to talk about the snapping. So snap will be here. We have a lot of options, and no matter the other object, we can snap to the grid, as you can see, we are snapping to the grid. If you zoom out, it will be snap to the grid, such as this. If you zoom in, it will be snap to the this grid. We didn't talk about the options which is here. We have here the wireframe, and it shows the object in the wireframe. We have the solid, we have the material preview, and we have the rendered. This is show only the colors, and this show lights and so on. As you can see, we have here the mesh, we have the curve, and we have a lot of options, but these options isn't shown by default, so you can go to the add-on. We have built-in a lot of add-ons that you can use, and the one of these, which is extra, using activating this extra object, you can add some object such as T-bot or so on. So if I select, we can use to make a diamond, and etc. and T-bot. So every scene has four items, which is your mesh and the curves. After that, you will add light, you will add camera, you will add materials. So you can add an environment and then hit the render. What about snapping? I have said that we have here an a cube, and we have a lot of options here. So I want to move the cube or move that T-bot to this vertex. So I will activate the snap, and after that I will move. I am saying that I want to move it to be here, or move to be here. I am using this option a lot. Or you can snap to the edge. Or you can snap to the volume. To the face, GZ, I want to move here. I'm snapping, but as you can see, it's not precise. I'm using only the vertex, or maybe the increment, to be snapping to the grid. In the next video or the next lesson, I will talk about the spin and the screw, and we will also talk about the proportional editing.